Welcome viewers. Let's start with our top focus this hour. Controversial Karnataka Minister Shivanand Patil has stoked a row yet again with his new anti-farmer remark. Now, in a bizarre statement, Patil claims that farmers wish for drought every year as that would mean that their loans will be waived off by the government. Now, this obnoxious claim comes even a few months after the same Congress Neta had earlier claimed that farmer suicides are rising as they want to claim compensation from the government.
ಇನ್ನ ರೈತರಿಗೆ ಏನಪ್ಪಾ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಒಂದೇ ಆಸೆ ಇರ್ತದೆ, ಮಗನ್ ಮ್ಯಾಗ ಮ್ಯಾಗ ಬರಗಾಲ ಬೀಳಿ ಅಂತೇಳಿ. ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಅದು ಸಾಲ ಮನ್ನಾ ಆಗ್ತದ. ಹಂಗ ಬಯಸ್ಬಾರ್ದು. ಅದ್ರಾಗೇನ್ ನೀವು ಬ್ಯಾಡ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಮೂರ್ ನಾಲ್ಕು ವರ್ಷಕ್ಕೆ ಒಂದ್ ಸರ್ತಿ ಬಂದೇ ಬರ್ತದ. ಆದ್ರೂ ಈ ಸರ್ತಿ ಬಂದದ್ ನೋಡಿದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಮೊನ್ನೆ ಸಿದ್ದರಾಮಯ್ಯ ಏನು ಹೇಳ್ಬಿಟ್ಟ, ಮೀಡಿಯಂ ಟರ್ಮ್ ಲೋನಿ ಮಧ್ಯಮ ಅವಧಿ ಲೋನಿಗೆ ನಾನು ಬಡ್ಡಿ ಬಿಡ್ತೀನಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಬಿಟ್ಟ. ಇನ್ ಕೆಲವೊಬ್ರು ಸಾಲಾನೇ ಸುಟ್ಟು ಬಿಟ್ಟಾರ, ನಿಮಗೇನು ಹೇಳಬೇಕಾಗಿಲ್ಲ ಅದು.
Now, this is the bizarre and obnoxious statement there by the Congress Neta, and BJP has called this statement unpardonable and said Chief Minister Siddaramaiah must ask this minister to apologize and also the controversial minister must be asked to resign.
I strongly condemn the statement of the Minister Shivanand Patil. It clearly shows recklessness of a responsible minister. Such a irresponsible statement regarding farmers is really unpardonable. I demand Honorable Chief Minister to call this minister immediately, ask him to apologize to the farmers of the state, and also I demand Chief Minister should take the resignation of the concerned minister, because this is not the first time. This is not first time the way Shivanand Patil is giving the statements. Repeatedly is issuing such statements, especially against farmers.
ಬರಗಾಲಕ್ಕೆ ರೈತರು ಕಾಯ್ತಿರ್ತಾರೆ ಸಾಲ ಮನ್ನಾ ಆಗಲಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಕಾಯ್ತು ಹೇಳುವ ಮೂಲಕ ರೈತ ಸಮುದಾಯವನ್ನು ಅಪಮಾನಿಸಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಇವ್ರನ್ನ ಮಂತ್ರಿ ಸ್ಥಾನದಲ್ಲಿ ಮುಂದುವರೆಸಿದ್ರೆ ಆ ಪಾಪಕ್ಕೆ ಕಾಂಗ್ರೆಸ್ ಹೊಣೆ ಆಗಬೇಕಾಗತ್ತೆ. ಇದು ಬಹುಶಃ ಅಧಿಕಾರದ ಅಹಂಕಾರದ ಒಂದು ಭಾವನೆ ಅವರಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ಮಾತಾಡಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ಅಧಿಕಾರದ ಪಿತ್ತ ನೆತ್ತಿಗೇರಿದಾಗ ಅಹಂಕಾರದಿಂದ ಸ್ಥಿತಪ್ರಜ್ಞತೆಯನ್ನು ಕಳ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾರಂತೆ. ಬಹುಶಃ ಈಗ ಇವರಿಗೆ ಶಿವಾನಂದ ಪಾಟೀಲ್ರಿಗೆ ಆಗಿರೋದು ಕೂಡ ಅಧಿಕಾರದ ಮದ ಅಹಂಕಾರ. ಮುಖ್ಯಮಂತ್ರಿಗಳಿಗೆ ನಾನು ವಿನಂತಿ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಬಯಸ್ತೇನೆ, ಮದ ನೀವೇ ಇಳಿಸ್ತೀರೋ ಅಥವಾ ಜನನೇ ನಿಮ್ಮನ್ನೂ ಸೇರಿಸಿ ಇಳಿಸಬೇಕು.
Joining me on the broadcast is my colleague Neha, who's joining us from Bengaluru. Neha, bizarre and obnoxious statement this coming in from the Congress Neta. Now, back in September, this is the same leader who had said that farmers are committing suicide. Farmer suicides are in fact rising so that they can get government compensation and aid. And now he's gone ahead and made yet another bizarre remark against the farmers. What's stopping the Siddaramaiah government from acting against him?
Well, that's right, Ashish. Rather shocking statement here coming in from Mr. Shivanand Patil there. And remember that, you know, in fact, he is the sugarcane minister here in the state of Karnataka, one that's very closely linked with the farmers. And here he goes on to say that farmers are waiting for a drought year after year only so they can claim the loan waiver. You know, it's absolutely, of course, appalling that such a statement has come in, and this for the second time from the minister over here in concern. This isn't the first time. He's not new to controversies. And despite that, we're seeing that no action has been taken. Remember, voices from within the Congress party now also suggesting that he should apologize, that this is wrong. But whether action will be taken against him or not is something that remains to be seen. Also, you know, in fact, to remind our viewers, we're now seeing that protests have started to begin across the state of Karnataka as far as the statement is concerned. And even at a time like this, while we're hearing a clarification now coming in from him, the clarification here is that the BJP is unnecessarily trying to politicize the issue. Remember that the statement over there is quite evident. If we are to keep the politics out of this entirely, you know, even for a common man hearing a statement like this today, irrespective of the politician or the party, is rather shocking to say the least, Ashish.
Right, Neha, this is the key takeaway there. Absolutely shocking statement coming in from a minister, and the fact that the Karnataka government hasn't acted on him, despite this being a repeated offense, makes it even more shocking. Appreciate you joining us on the broadcast with all those details. Shifting our focus.